You can definitely evade him by using doppelganger.
Here we go. Catch one. Snowball. Hi, S4. How you doing? And I like it. Axe moves to the front, and there's your first blood. Kaiser, first short for blood. Kaiser Sose, gets the kill just right there. And it's going to be LC who strike first. Moscow 5, that's how you do it.
I really like the way that... I think this is smarter, though, if you think about it, because he's already 325 movement speed. He doesn't really need boots. He gets plus 9 damage. They're actually going on S4, a little surprisingly. There's the stud as well. Big fissure. There's the call. S4 is getting low, and that is going to be his death, but X falls right after. Maybe Puppy will die. There's the ice shards or whatever the heck that's called. Puppy will go down, and maybe Tusk Living. Nope. The Null Talisman's going to do it, and maybe even Crow's going to get a triple here. He's got two in Fable.
Got it.
And I think that's going to be it.
Wow. Double kill on Kuro. How about that for a null, huh? So he gets it done.
It worked out. He got the mana, but we see Queen of Pain coming in. A couple right clicks. Good deny by S4. Very likely that he'd do that. Good enough player to realize that that's going to result in the possibility of deny. So he gets the deny.
Jeez. Well played. Well played. And you were right. It is Ice Shards.
Value of Snowball. They are going again. Great split from S4. They might be able to turn this. They should go on the Tusk probably, but they actually change targets a bit. Zai comes in as well. Call, but he gets lifted in there. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Evade that damage, and then now you're going back in for the fight. Wave of Terror comes as well. Zai's getting a bit low, and Axe proves to be a little too tanky here. A couple more nukes. Gets him. 145 damage. Thank God for no talismans, guys. The snowball comes to actually pull the Tusk to a bad position, but Quap shows up, going for another kill, picks off Zai. Now going on to Kroki. Doesn't even have to ulti for this couple right clicks, and that's going to be a dead Skywrath Mage. Tries to buy out before he dies, but nothing he can do there. And they're going toe-to-toe with Secret here.
Getting her to go off to the right-hand side. Now he looks to turn around on a puppy. Spirit Lance is going to fly.
Ooh, he's in.
But yeah, now he's in trouble. Kuro finds the real one. Zones him back.
Wow, look at the damage.
He just stops. He goes down. He turns back with a Spirit Lance. Can he get a kill in return? No. That smoke's not going to disjoint the tower hit. And
just slightly too close. That would have actually kept him alive, though, because that was an illusion. He was far away from the tower. More fighting on the top lane, but you know, we didn't have to tell you that. Goes in. Arteezy solo.
He's dead. He gets to go down. Soundstrike's going to be there. S4 jumps in, gets the clap. Vengeful Spirit gets blasted and nuked. Meanwhile, Zai gets dunked right there from Madara, trying to fly back and away. It's a 3-for-3 all day from top to bottom of this map, but it doesn't stop there. Madara goes toe-to-toe with S4. Here comes Kaiser, moves in. Fissure connects, takes out Brew. Walk in, Echo Slam, fishes out the other. Madara walks away with a triple kill. What the hell are we watching right now? 10 minutes in, 18-14. Top of the net worth for Kaiser right here with RTZ right behind. Get a little bit of mana here. That's no lasso, but he is... Hi, how you doing?
This
just
could be
jumps over.
Oh,
him.
Loses the vision. There it is. Stun comes through. Needs a bit more damage. It's so close. Oh!
Gets it done. Puppy
what a dunk.
An echo off right before he dies. Snowball for the save, but it's going on to Arteezy. Can they burst him down in time? They can.
Jeez.
Getting blown up right there. 3-for-1 trade. Happily traded right there for Secret. Lane. Madara. He's going to get, ganked right now. Snipe flies through. Boom. See ya. Gets sniped on down. Arteezy grabs that kill, and they make it two kills across the map. 20-20 now, even up a mid lane. It doesn't stop there. Cyclone now going to be throwing up the Tusk. Vengeful Spirit trying to get away. Slowly burn. Flame break. It's Zai who gets that kill. Kuro barely alive. No! Goes down to those ice shards. I give my life to get you, Kuro. Screw you, says the Tusk. But
I don't think that's worth it, man.
It's not worth 3-for-1 trade where Seek it. I mean,
he just needs a Diffusal Blade. It's going to be a while till you can get it.
If you're getting a Vanguard, I imagine you're in a rough game.
Oh, it's the silence.
No, you're not doing anything. And, man, he's done. They can't even get the swap to save him.
Oh, look at the slow. They had a slow on the snowball as well, so that means Tusk is just in a bad spot.
That is just an awkward snowball going nowhere real quick. Shards trying to keep someone back. It's S4 for now, but Casper, they get the jump, they get the silence, and they will get the kill. Nice and
maybe
set up on
my left.
They want a 2-for maybe on the Madara thereafter, and they could get it. Snipe will fly in. Connects. Kuro, though, very low. Goes down as the trade, a worthy trade. And here comes that snowball again. This one not slowed. Brings in some help. Puppy gets uppercutted. Swap back save, but gets taken care of with that fissure. And now Vengeful Spirit, the last little hope here for LC.
Doesn't get the kill.
Can't even get the kill. Puppy walks away with about 30 life.
Tranquil's paying off there. 4 armor. Not to
do, and you could still do with the hero. But many teams don't consider, but right now, Yule's up. Vengeful Spirit will be knocked forward, gets everything off, and then goes down. So that's a quick kill sacrifice. The rest of LC are like, we're done here.
Got a blink on
Sniper.
Go. This is a counter to mobility, or it's a mobility advantage item, but he's using it as a counter to it. Oh, can the catch axe here? He looks in trouble. They need to stop him from blinking. There it is. They should be good.
Yeah, no call for you. Sorry, Madara. But here's Kaiser trying to zone them back. It's Yules himself. And they still slowly bring down the giant Madara here. And there's going to be the Fissure setup. Puppy always there and behind to kind of help out with an assist. And it's Zai who cleans out the kill. Now in a mega kill streak on your
bit of ganking on both ways. Actually a swap coming. Going on Crow. He doesn't get the high ground, so he should be killed here. No chop, unfortunately. Moves speed around. Really nice. Quap ult comes out, catches two. BKB, but a little bit late, so her HP is low. And now she's got to retreat to the high ground. Arteezy's up chasing. He's got a Mjolnir. Tons of damage coming from him. That's going to finish up the Axe. He does reflect a lot of damage back to himself, though. PL Illusions doing a whole lot of nothing in the backside. Back goes down. That's a gem on the ground. They got to defend that because they need it to deward. And now Quap escaping. Arteezy's got a shrapnel in 2 seconds.
Puppy sees it. He grabs the gem. And they can't make
when you're out of mana. But he can do an ulti combo and still have leftover. Swap going to the high ground. Into an immediate punch on S4. Can they get the killer? A good execution. Can they chop him? They're going to need the attack speed. Doesn't get it. But looks like an ult on. No, he keeps changing targets. There it is. Vengeful Spirit is in some trouble. Gets picked off. Going after Crow now. Crow yules it up.
Quap
ult catches Arteezy at least, but still chasing. No axe call. And now Arteezy looking to kite if possible. But now he's got to fight the Quap. He's pretty much here or dead. Great Echo Slam from Puppy. Arteezy going to TP back. He might not make it. He doesn't. Follow up by Phantom Lancer, still chasing it. It looks like LC finally going to win a fight here, chasing out Puppy. Another Enchant Totem buyback from Arteezy, though. He wants to kill the Phantom Lancer. He's got to dodge the hit. He can't get it off in time. Great Fissure from Puppy. And it looked good for him, but that's...
They lose everyone at the end of it. Arteezy gets a double kill after buying back.
He can initiate, pull somebody mid. Puppy only has a Fissure, though.
It's Madara. Pulls the axe back in forward. Kuro waiting before he lines up the Mystic Flare. Maybe doesn't want to go into the Blade Mail, but it doesn't matter. Madara ends up going down. Now Puppy, very little on mana. Still getting the job done. Yule's going to be connecting under PL. PL,
Doppel
gets away, but does not get to the low ground. Does still get swapped back. Oh, saved from Vengeful Spirit.
There we go. Illusion's doing damage. Finally, Puppy's low at 200. Still chasing him, though. He's got to jump on the Sniper. I think that's what I'd go for. He's going in. Melee range, hitting Arteezy. Can he get the Lightning? Prox goes high ground again. Big flame break there, and he's stuck in the trees.
Oh.
All right, he can double gank once. No,
double
yules again.
Gaming? Double?
No. Doesn't do it. He's getting close to getting carry. Like, think if he got a Diffusal Blade earlier, you know?
Yeah, no.
Vision over here. Is Ice spotting heroes?
They get the kill. If they get anyone picked off here, double. Gets last one, wants to go for the next target.
Good snowball.
Vengeful Spirit was not an appetizing treat, but might have to be now as the swap back Yules is there. Does decide to get a hold of Vengeful Spirit, takes out that one, makes it two-man kill. They could go back for the Roche if they want to, or they could go for high ground. We'll see Secret as they plant themselves in mid. They're going to go for the high ground. Jump in, lasso, Madara.
Great
swap back immediately.
Refresher,
double lasso
though.
And gets him again. Sorry, buddy. I got another one for you.
Refresh this one, Venge. Good try.
Pulls him back, but he's a meaty boy. He's going to walk back into the base and into a snowball. And they're like, no, get back in that battle. And they throw right back towards Zai. Meanwhile, S4 splits. They take down the Tusk. And now PL makes a go onto S4, who's trying to make a go onto the Vengeful Spirit. Eventually takes him down. RZZ goes into the base, moving on forward. And now he's on the backside of a bad fight with PL, potentially, in late man mode. He does have the Aegis, however. He'll use it. Gets expended, relaxed, barely alive. Has to walk away. Doppelganger trying to make it back to the base. Arteezy actually doesn't stay and get off like an assassinate or anything. Just gets silenced up and goes back on the outside.
And look at that net worth difference. That was a panda attacking a PL, and the sniper had like, what is this, 6k gold advantage over him, and he was actually fighting competitively.
Yeah.
Like, Peel's actually very strong in a fight. Look at this Kuroki's easily getting it cleaned up as well. The Illusion goes after him.
Nope, force that
to low
forces.
Ground. Where's the PL right now? I don't
Team
even know.
Team Star Wars over here. They got the Force, and they're definitely using it here. Mid lane, there's the jump in. They wipe out everyone. Double buyback comes out from both. Relaxes PL. Same with Kaiser. And it's Secret, though, going for these uncontested racks. At least no tier 3 in the way. And they're going to look to go in and try to clear them out.
Spams out the Illusions, trying to slow him down, reducing Arteezy's mana by a very small amount. But the Rax is definitely going to fall here.
Yeah.
Got a respawn from Tusk. He's going to TP kind of aggressively. They might snowball in for this one. We'll see. Silence on Arteezy. Still chasing BKB now on Quap. He can do a blink ult in 1 second. If they can get Zai, that'd be pretty good. He's pretty low. S4 getting low as well. Venge got blown up, and now Secret's gonna chase. Too.
Oh, they turn back. This could be the end of the game if they wipe here. And now a desperation snowball to keep Tusk alive.
He doesn't have a blink, so he's gonna die from this one here.
Travels forward, shot. Ho ho ha ha. Arteezy's gonna get the kill there, and the Rax will go down. They take down both supports, snow bite back, Tusk out for a minute. Secret now with the upper hand, get the first real base damage done. Feeling pretty tasty, like it might be a 2-0 series run here. Secret move to the other side, then they already take down the tier 3 in the mid lane. Raxes will be exposed there, but they're going to lose
cooldown. 26 seconds left. Can they kill Puppy first? This would be huge. There's the call. Axe as well. And they're going to even quap ulti this. Couple right clicks. That's going to lose a Tusk for them. Oh, he snowballs in. He's going in. Great stun on top of Arteezy. Another call they needed in a second here. Here it is. Call going on. Arteezy, any reflection damage is getting kind of low, but not enough being done. PL, they're getting so low. Way too much AP damage. And that's going to be good game there.
Wow. Okay. It was close there for a bit. They make Secret sweat for it, but overall, it's just Secret Gaming doing what they do. Put together a good draft. Really hard to really decide anyone on that team who could be the MVP. Everyone really pulled their own weight. They did their job, and it was just impressive performance. Props, though, to the London Conspiracy Group, man. They put a funky, fresh lineup there with the Tusk and aggro tri-lane getup. They keep us entertained with all the action there in the top lane.
Made them fight, and they went even for such a long time. They just needed more output out of their Phantom Lancer, I feel. It's really about that Diffusal Blade. If you would have skipped, I think the Vanguard was fine. The Treads was fine.